This is a podcast, but it's more of a video series podcast. So it's a little
Let's
different. Yeah, we're trying to do
I'm
things
ready.
Different
I'm hyped.
Yeah, we're trying to do things different out here. Fades by Morales is in here with me today, as y'all can hear him. You want to introduce yourself? Tell him a little about yourself, bro.
What's good? It's your boy, Fades by Morales. See, that's my thing. You know what I'm saying?
It is your thing.
Because, hey, that shit happened super organically, too, I swear. Because I would always feel the beat. Because I'm doing the voiceover, the beat's playing in my headphones. And I'm like, you know, like feeling that beat. So I did it subconsciously, but now I do it consciously now. So
now you do it consciously? Now you know
But now I know it's about to happen.
That's dope.
It's part in there. But yeah, I'm a barber by not by trade, but by passion. That's what I'm passionate about. I'm from Kansas City. And I keep all my nephews and mostly family and friends, really close friends, keep them clean.
That's what's up. How long you been cutting for, bro?
Well, it depends. Like when I was a little kid. Oh, like seriously?
Yeah.
Oh, like I've had a barber chair for 3 years.
That's dope.
I had a barber chair for 3 years. But before that, like I would cut my grandfather's hair, you know, back in the rancho, you know, just on the front porch. And I always remember my grandfather would always be like, my abuelito would be like, yo quiero que él me corte mi pelo y nadie más. And I was only like 11.
Oh. Real damn. That's crazy.
Right.
That's a lot of trust he had in you, bro. Especially the grandpa like that? Nah, dude. They usually don't trust nobody. Did you have a good relationship with your grandpa?
Oh, man. Okay. So, that one, not so much, but the other one raised me. So,
okay.
That's 100 with him all day. That's fair.
So, you've been cutting seriously for 3 years now. You're based out of Kansas City. You've been cutting for a long time, like a long, long time before that. But you started taking it seriously 3 years ago, right? That sounds extremely familiar to me. Full honesty.
Oh, shit. So
I've been cutting seriously for 2 years now. And then keep in mind that 1 year was a pandemic, so I cut very little. Till today, I still cut very little. Same thing. I cut family. I cut friends, close friends, to be honest with you. No, I'm not a professional barber. You could say that I was a professional barber at one point in my life. And that was like 10 years ago when I lived in Mexico, actually like 12, 13 years ago now, when I lived in Mexico, because I did do like a lot of house calls. A lot of people found out I knew how to cut hair because I also cut my hair when I was younger, cut all the homies in the block when I was younger. My older brother taught me how to cut hair.
Yeah, I did that shit too.
Yeah, he taught me how to cut hair when I was 12, 13. My older brother actually gets down with a pair of clippers. He doesn't really
do that. Oh, no shit.
He gets down with the pair of clippers like crazy good. I don't know where he gets it from. He taught me. I cut up everybody. I went to Mex, lived out there for like 5-6 years, and somebody found out I cut hair. They told someone else. When you least knew it, I had like 20 plus people that I cut their hair like weekly. So I basically was a part-time barber. You know what I mean? I would do it. I got money for it. There's no licenses out there. I just had my clippers in a little case and I just rolled house to house. You know what I mean? Yeah, it's crazy. It was pretty cool though. Little side hustle. And then when I came back to the States, I didn't cut for the longest time. I cut my own hair. Then I had a son and I was like, I'm not going to let nobody touch his hair. Like I'm going to start cutting his hair. My brother-in-laws, you know, cousins, my brothers, everybody, even my pops, like everybody needs a haircut. I was like, I'll just start cutting hair again. And I got serious into it. Start washing.
All right, hold on. Not to interrupt you.
Yeah.
When you decided right then.
Yeah.
I swear I never asked him this.
No, yes.
I'm just assuming. I'm assuming right now.
Yes.
That first pair of clippers you went to go buy was a Wall Senior.
Close. Extremely close.
Oh, damn.
I got a Wall Magic Clip, a corded Magic Clip.
Oh, okay.
You know that setup, the Magic Clip with the razor edger that they give you? So it's like a little combo. They share one cable. It's got the quick connect. It was like $90 on Amazon.
Yeah. Hey, those cabrones, they stole my freaking idea.
They did, right? They did, straight up. So I got that set up, and soon enough, like a couple months, I started getting really into it. And here's the thing about me is I've always done some type of artwork in the past, some artistic of some
Right.
I did music, I did art, I tattooed for a while. That was my other side hustle in Mexico. I tattooed. I did all kinds of stuff in my life with art, and I didn't have anything more going on at the time. So I told myself this could be my new outlet. You know what I mean? To just
Bro, I seen you draw one time when you was doing that talent show.
Yeah.
That shit was freehand. That shit was dope. Cool.
I appreciate that, because the thing about it is I used to do tattoo designs. That was what I used to design. So like my artwork was like people coming to me and saying, hey, I want this crazy ass idea of like this dragon coming towards a flower with my girl's name on. I was like, say less. Like, I'll draw it up for you. We'll slap it on your face. I don't care. You know what I mean?
Oh, so, Game of Thrones ass little boy.
So we did that. You know what I mean? So I'm from Cali. I lived in Cali. When I didn't live in Mexico, I would live in California, all over Cali, specifically Northern California. So much love to Southern California, but I'm not a fan of living out there. It's different. I work out there, like off and on, believe it or not. Like the company has a corporate office down there, so I travel a lot down there. It's cool, but I don't know. Just this feels like home. I live in the Bay Area, in the East Bay Area. Like perfect weather, just, you know, everything's just nice. It's expensive, but it's nice. There's a lot of opportunity out here. So yeah, that's a little bit about me, how I got into barbering, how long I've been barbering. Technically speaking, I've been cutting hair genuinely for a year because the pandemic, right? So like for a year,
right.
Genuinely cutting. So if y'all see my messed up cuts on YouTube or whatever, don't trip. I've only been cutting for a year, seriously.
Man, quit for it. That's dope. You got good cuts, dog.
I appreciate that, bro. Appreciate that.
It's because you're a meticulous dude. You're a meticulous vato. I can tell by your guidelines. When I look at your tutorials, I'm looking at your guidelines, right? And it's like you see, I do carpentry work, también.
Yeah.
But I would have to use a level and shit. Hey, you know what? I started thinking about that shit the other day too. I was like, man, I think this vato uses a squadra.
No.
And then puts his guidelines in it.
I use my glasses, the top of my glasses, to make sure. No, none of that, bro.
I was about to get on Amazon right now and just start ordering glasses and shit.
No, none of that, bro.
Pero si es sin aumento.
Yeah, but tell them where they can find you on IG, bro.
At Face by Morales. At Face by Morales is all my shit. My YouTube, Face by Morales. IG is at Face by Morales. That's all I got right now. I don't have all that TikTok or Twitter or any of that.
TikTok for you?
Nah, man. I've been thinking about it though. Yeah. My daughter got it, and she's doing her own editing, cabrón. Like,
that's dope.
Top. She's doing good, dog. Like, I'm proud of her.
That's dope, man. That's legit. My daughter does a little bit of TikTok too. She used to dance. I think I told you that.
Professionally.
Yeah, so it's her thing. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. That's what's up. Mm-hmm. You can find me at IV_Mac, M-A-C. The name of my channel is IV Mac Cuts. Faze by Morales' YouTube channel is Faze by Morales. So make sure y'all check us out. This is a whole different channel. We came together and wanted to do something different. So let's talk about what we're going to be talking about today, which is, again, going to be chopped up into different days of the week. Let me find my list here. So we took some notes, y'all. We're ready for this.
Professionals.
Yeah. So a few, we're going to be talking about barber challenges. It is a hot thing on the net, on the web, on the interweb right now with all these challenges. We're also talking about the new Babyliss Influencer Edition trimmers. I know everybody, dude, have you noticed the amount of videos of people uploading those? Like 35 different reviews about the same trimmer.
All Lowe's cut it, huh?
Yeah, for the most part. Or patty cuts. I feel like those are the two that everybody's buying. Colorway.
That's BS.
I know.
We'll get into that. We'll get to that.
And then we're going to do a quick YouTube channel shout out. So if you want to know the channels that me and Fades listen to or watch, it's different out here. So the channels that we watch, we're going to be talking a little bit about that. Giving some people some shout outs, hopefully it helps their channel. But if not, just maybe whoever's listening can check out that content. And then last, wild card. Fades is actually going to be bringing up the wild card today, and we'll do back to back. So he'll do 1 week, I'll do another week. Just going to throw something random at you, not even tell you what it is until we get to it. But yeah, that's it. That's the introduction. Let's get into it.
Let's go.